Hey everybody, today we're recapping every Digimon introduced in 2020 and 2021 with a little bit of bite-sized commentary. So first off, Abadamon, one of the main villains of Digimon Adventure 2020. Cool design, very Full Metal Alchemist. This Digimon was not seen in the anime, but is very good partner material in my opinion. Agumon, Bond of Friendship. This is from Last Evolution Kizuna. It's an okay final form, didn't blow me away. Algumon, the whole line. So there's Algumon Baby. This one is also pretty good, but not as good as Algumon Baby 2, which was seen in episode 1 of Digimon Adventure 2020. Algumon Child is the one that evolves, and Agumon and Greymon fight at the end of that first episode. And Algumon Adult is what they take on in episode 2 when Yamato and Garurumon join the team. A decent villainous line for sure. Baboon Gamon is from the virtual pet game and the card game. No anime appearance yet, but a solid design. I like the rocky elements. Balukimon was seen in the later episodes of Digimon 2020, but introduced in 2020. This is an okay design, doesn't do too much for me. Bibimon is part of the Pulse Line family, a big kind of mascot for the Vital Bracelet in 2021. Really love this form. Just going alphabetically, Boutmon is here as well. I really like the diversity of the Pulsemon line, which you'll be seeing as we cover more, like Bulkmon, just kind of completely different from Boutmon, but very cool in its own way. Dark Maeldramon. This Digimon feels like it existed in the past, like these colors are very Cyberdramon. I really like this one. Dokimon is perfect in my opinion. This is a true example of less is more. I just love this little guy. Dun Devimon, obviously iconic episode 24 of Digimon Adventure 2020. Great design, very Venom inspired. Entomon, also from Digimon Adventure 2020, and a really antagonistic force. His episode was quite scary, so I like this design, it's great. Eosmon is the villain from Digimon Last Evolution Kizuna. Solid design, didn't leave too much of a lasting memory though, if I'm being honest. And same goes for its follow-up forms, the Perfect and the Ultimate. They did their jobs as villains, but they aren't stealing the show. Exermon is another optional alt evolution from the Pulsemon line, again just showing off how diverse that line can be when you're playing the Vital Bracelet. Very cool. Aizmon, another one that kind of has that Full Metal Alchemist inspiration. It came around in I think episode 16 of Digimon Adventure 2020. Same with Aizmon Scatter Mode, which is a smaller form. Gabumon Bond of Friendship is also from Last Evolution Kizuna and is Gabumon's final form. I think this is better than the Agumon design. Gan Vivormon was actually a fan design, one of five fan designed Digimon, which is really cool, really cute and original idea. I like this one a lot. Ghostmon is great, kind of looks like Palmon underneath the hat, and I just can't believe we're 20 years in and this is the first time a Digimon has been called Ghostmon. That doesn't feel right. Gogmamon had a really great Mimi episode in Adventure 2020. Not a favorite, but not offensive. Gusokumon is kind of the same way. I have the same feelings where this is a great Digimon antagonist, just a villain of the week Digimon, but I don't think this would be anybody's partner or any main big threat. Heavy Leomon came from Digimon ReArise. Pretty cool design, very Megazord. I like Junkmon a lot. I thought this Digimon was actually an older Digimon. I only recently found out it was really introduced in 2020. Feels like a classic Digimon design. Kazuchimon is another Pulsemon line, and this one is really cool, very samurai style. Machmon is kind of this haunted motorcycle, and its episode was pretty solid. I think this is a cool design. It kind of has like a Greymon or Metal Greymon looking face and the skull helmet thing. Madomon, another one of those fan designed Digimons I mentioned. Very cute. I wonder if the creator had a dog like this in real life. Manticoremon is one of those, again, just kind of villain of the week Digimon. I could see the kids in any given show fighting this thing, but I don't think this is going to be anybody's favorite Digimon. Marine Chimeramon, same thing. Not even as an insult, it's just Metal Greymon Alteros mode. Yeah, this was a huge surprise. If you want to know more about what this thing even is, then check out one of my other videos. Just type Metal Greymon Alteros mode on my channel. Great inclusion, in my opinion. Mimicmon also rules. I want to see this in the show. It would be great for Digimon Ghost Game. Midamamon is a really beautiful kind of fox spirit design. It reminds me of something like Kyubimon. Morphmon was the kind of innocent version of the antagonist in Digimon Last Evolution Kizuna without getting too much into the plot. Really great. This could truly be a new mascot Digimon or a new partner Digimon. Namakemon, this one's really cool. It feels very Pokemon to me, and it's also a Pulsemon alt line. You can see really just how diverse that line is. This was another big bad in Digimon Adventure 20. In fact, technically the biggest bad. It's simple but effectively spooky. Same goes for Nidhoggmon, which was this giant, again, kind of got the Full Metal Alchemist eyes thing happening. Very cool, very horror inspired. Omedamon, this is that Metabots kind of April Fool's collaboration, but I count this as a real Digimon, especially since the Vital Bracelet has the Metabots chips now. I love this guy. He's awesome. Parasaurmon doesn't do too much for me. There's nothing offensive about this design, but it's here. It's cool. Sure, let's take it. Piranamon, pretty imposing, pretty scary. I can see this just being an underwater enemy in any given anime episode. Pomamon is kind of ugly in a cute way. I actually really like Pomamon. Kind of Sora's partner temporarily in Digimon Adventure 2020. And of course, here he is. Pulsemon is the Digimon we've been talking about so much in this 2020 section. This is the rookie form that most people would be familiar with. Very mascot. Had the potential to be the new kind of face of Digimon before Gumamon showed up in 2021. Piantomon is another fan-made Digimon. Very cool, very monster rancher, like that rabbit. Rebellimon, at first this design felt a little over the top for me, too edgy, but the Rebellimon episode of Digimon Adventure 2020 is one of the best, so I gotta give it to Rebellimon. Regalisusmon is another cool underwater enemy. Maybe the pattern is I don't really care for the underwater Digimon too much. Runnermon is one more Pulsemon evolution line. Once again, repeating myself, such a diverse line. Pulsemon to Runnermon, it reminds me of like Vmon to Raidramon, and I like this form a lot. Rurimon, another fan design Digimon. I think this is probably my favorite of the bunch. Maybe kind of cheating since that's just straight up a blue Agumon underneath with some horns, but what an amazing little kind of scholar wizard. Sangomon, another great instance of less is more. I think this guy is fantastic, and there's a little Finding Nemo in there. What else can I say? He's great. Tsunarizimon is another Digimon. I don't know how this didn't exist prior to 2020. This looks like a classic Digimon out of 1999. Tobiamon is another one that's okay. He's an underwater Digimon. I guess I've shown my bias that they're not doing too much for me. Sure, I could see us fighting him in an episode of Ghost Game. Maybe Toropiamon had a great episode, and I think this Digimon is really cool and imposing. And a treat for fans of like grassy, leafy Digimon like Palmon and Lilymon. Wergarurumon Sagittariusmon, so another Digimon that appeared in 2020, kind of out of nowhere. If you want more information on what the heck this form even is, I have a video on that, so just type in Sagittarius mode into the Digino and you'll find that video for sure, that explainer. Fantastic design, really paying respect to the original while also expanding in 2020. Abadamon Core from the finale of Digimon Adventure 2020, an amazing rival. Achillesmon, another great Vital Bracelet introduction, really strong design. I haven't really seen a lot of Trojan stuff in Digimon. Agitarmon, not my favorite, but a pretty cool inclusion for the plant-loving Digimon community. Blacktailmon Uber, one of my favorites of the year. Definitely a huge surprise when it showed up in episode 1, and it seems like it's going to have a ton of power and importance in the new show. Bloomlordmon, very Omegamon inspired. I love the idea. It makes me think of what if there was an Omegamon where instead of Wargreymon and Metal Garurumon, it had like Rosemon's arm and Vikemon's arm or something like that. Climbmon is not my favorite, but probably will be adored by people who like the Tentomon line and other bug style Digimon. Divemon reminds me of a Street Shark, so I gotta give him the thumbs up for that. Frostvelgermon, pretty cool. Not a favorite of mine, but very Articuno, so I gotta give it a thumbs up there as well. Frozemon is kind of like a snowplow, but I kind of generally like the train aesthetic that has permeated Digimon for 20 years, so I'm giving it the seal of approval. Gaiomon Ito Mode, also from Digimon ReArise. Not that different from the original, if my eyes aren't failing me, and just a little bit too much going on here. It's cool. It's a little edgelord. Gigantic Pumpmon was a raid boss in the Vital Bracelet. What a cool way to introduce new Digimon is to have them be these raid bosses. Really neat. Nothing spectacular, but really fun. Goromon, another Digimon that looks like it could be a classic Digimon or even a Pokemon design from the early 2000s. And same could be said for Hiarimon, which has, I could just picture running into this playing like Pokemon Black or White or something like that. Hydramon, amazing villainous looking Digimon. I would love to see some characters battling this thing in a Digimon anime series. Kodo Kugumon Child, nothing really new going on here. This is very classic Digimon as well. Commandamon is just absolutely S tier, one of the best inclusions of the Digimon Adventure 2020 anime. Base Digimon's favorite monster, just the best, just a fantastic design. Lovely Angemon, I would love to see this character in the anime in some form or another. Really cool. I love seeing more Angemon and Angewomon variants, so bring on more like this. Pistmon, also really cool. I like the idea of like a Kamen Rider, or more specifically Mumen Rider from One Punch Man looking Digimon. He looks great. Raremon is just intentionally gross. I can't really like knock points for saying it's ugly because it's supposed to be ugly, so you know, mission accomplished. Shivamon's got this very neat sort of metallic lotus design that I have a lot of fondness for. Really cool. Shroudmon, probably not anybody's favorite. Sorry if there's Shroudmon stands out there. He's okay. I can't really see him appearing in a major role in any anime series. Tsunamon is another fun one, similar to Goromon and Hiarimon. I could see this existing like 15 years ago. It just feels like a classic Digimon. And we also have Vulturemon, who is kind of like the epitome of those memes about what Digimon evolve into, where it's like it's a cat and then a fridge and then a dragon with a gun. That's kind of what we're looking at right here. Classic Digimon. So now looking at the protagonists, the lead Digimon of the new series, Digimon Ghost Game, starting with Peonmon. Haven't seen him in the anime yet, but I actually love these baby and in-training forms. Bosomon is the same way. It's especially cute knowing what he's about to look like as Angoramon. An amazing design. We don't often see rookies this big. He's bigger than a human and can fly with those ears. It's a very cute, very fun design. Digivolves into Simbare Angoramon, who a lot of people pointed out kind of feels like King Kazuma from Summer Wars, which I think is awesome. And then there's Lamortamon. We've seen this ultimate form teased through the Vital Bracelet, the new DIM cards, and it's my least favorite of the ultimates, I would say, but I see what they're going for, kind of more devilish and bat-like and brutal. But moving on to the Jellymon line, we have Puyomon. I'm always a big fan of the jelly-looking Digimon, so more the merrier. And the same can be said about Puyo-Yomon, which is just another great Digimon jelly, so more welcome to the family. And then, of course, Jellymon. I think I've declared in an earlier video review that Jellymon's my favorite of the new rookies. I think that is still the case, just an incredible design, even better in the show. Tesla Jellymon is part of a pattern I've noticed where when I see the official key art, I'm not sold on the champion forms, but once I see them in the show, they look amazing. So I really like Tesla Jellymon. It's this great middle phase before the ultimate. Thetismon or Tetismon, not my favorite ultimate. A little better than Lamortmon. I need to see it in action though. I think maybe once I see it animated, I'll fall in love with it, but right now I'm not so crazy about it. I think Tesla Jellymon is way cooler. For Gamamon, we start with Kyurimon. Super cute, just another classic baby Digimon. I can picture all the kids holding their baby Digimon at the end of the series. There's Gurimon, just a great in-between from Kyurimon and Gamamon. Nothing really substantial here, although it adopts the eyes of Gamamon. And then Gamamon, just an incredible lead Digimon. I saw even on Reddit, they were having a poll to see who is the ultimate Digimon protagonist. It was between Agumon and Gyomon and Vimon and all those, and I think Gamamon won. Maybe there's recency bias, but he's just an incredible design. And we see him evolve later into Betel Gamamon, another one that when I saw the art, I wasn't convinced on. So definitely I encourage you to watch the show, because Betel Gamamon in motion is a thing of beauty, really cool design. And same for Kaos Gamamon when he's flying. I really love what they've done with him so far, with the wonder that Kaos Gamamon expresses when he's flying. Like, he's definitely still childlike and amazed by his own powers. Huizen Gamamon is like this absolute tank Digimon in his episode 12 debut. Probably my least favorite of these three RGB Gamamon forms. And then we have Gulis Gamamon, who we haven't quite seen yet. He's been teased twice in the anime, and he's available in the Vital Bracelet if you play that. Very cool, very promising. I guess technically a champion, somewhere in between champion and ultimate. We don't exactly know how power scaling works in the series yet. And finally, we don't have any megas for any of these guys yet, but we do have this ultimate form, Kano Weismon. Really just a kind of magnificent dragon, like not like a monstrous kind of Metal Greymon is a little messy intentionally, and this guy is kind of like, feels like he could be like a godlike Digimon or something like that, but we'll have to see again once he's in motion in the anime what we think about him. So that is every Digimon introduced in 2020 and 2021. Let me know what you thought, let me know who your favorites are. It should be clear who my favorites are, but I'll put them in a pinned comment as well down below, just so it's explicitly clear. All right, thanks so much for watching. Subscribe if you enjoy stuff like this, and I'll see you in the next video.